गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स. ऑन सैटरडे आई वॉज मेकिंग यू रिवाइज नरेशंस. सो वी हैव डन रिविजन ऑफ फर्स्ट काइंड ऑफ इंटेरोगेटिव टाइप दैट यू कैन से डब्ल्यू एच टाइप. सो टूडे आई हैव प्लान टू टीच यू नेक्स्ट टाइप क्वेश्चन फॉर्म दैट योर क्वेश्चन स्टार्ट्स विद हेल्पिंग वर्ब. वेन योर क्वेश्चन स्टार्ट्स विद हेल्पिंग वर्ब इट कम्स इन द कैटेगरी ऑफ क्वेश्चन टाइप टू. For example, do, does, is, am, are, was, were, can, could, may, might. If your question starts with this, for example, can I use your pen? Can you come here? Do you know him? Does she go there every day? Okay, have you done your work? So all these are questions, but all these questions starts with helping verb, and there are different rules to do these sentences. Because in that question type one, I was told you that in place of comma, inverted comma, you will be writing nothing, and WH type question will remain same. For example, I said to you, what is your name? I asked you what your name was, and I told you that this helping verb will be shifted to last. So today let's do question form narrations. Narration, question type two. Narration, question type two. Okay. Narration, question type two. So, how to do? For example, if your sentence starts with any of the helping verb. Now, these helping verb are also known as auxiliary verbs. Okay. This rule will be implemented if your question starts with bache, write down, listen carefully, then you write down, and you have to write down as it is in your fair notebook, so that during your exam preparation you will not face any kind of difficulty. By looking at all these rules at a glance, you will be able to understand, you'll be able to revise it. Okay, if your question starts with like, is, am, are, was, were, do, does, did, can, could, will, shall, may, might. Okay, so if your question starts with is, am, are, was, were, do, does, did, can, could, will, shall, may, might, then follow this rule. So what is the rule? For example, I said to you, has he invited you to lunch? Has he invited you to lunch? So I said to you, has he invited you to lunch? So I said to you, this reported verb, this is known as what? It is known as reporting verb. This reporting verb will change into ask. Okay, very simple rule that you should know these terms, that said to. This rule is applicable when this reporting verb is given in past tense. So this said to, this reporting verb will change into asked. So I asked you, in place of comma and inverted comma, nothing will be written. I will be taking more example, Aditya, then I will be explaining you. I have taken only single example. Okay, So if it starts with helping verb like has, so you are supposed to use here if or whether. You can write down if also. You can write down whether. If he had invited, now you is a second person. Second person will change according to object. So this you will change according to this you. It means it will remain same you. So I asked you if he had invited you to lunch. Clear? I asked you if he had invited you to lunch. So this said to will change into asked. This has he invited you to lunch? This question form will change into assertive, but it in place of comma inverted comma, no conjunction will be used. And this sentence will start with if or whether. So this is the rule that you have to keep in your mind. If your question starts with WH, then same, WH will remain same. But here it is starting with the helping verb, then this auxiliary verb will change into past verb. Like if is given, was, if was were is given, had been, okay. If do is given, it will change into did. If may is given, it will be changed into might. Can will change into could. Should will remain should. Aditya should will remain should. Okay? Aditya is asking about should. Aditya is still raising his hand. Yes, Aditya, beta, what is your doubt?
Ma'am, please repeat the formation of the sentence once more.
Okay. Suppose if your question is starting with helping verb, like is, am, are, was, were, do, does, did, can, could, then this rule will be applicable. Aditya, did you attend a Saturday class? Tell me, did you attend Saturday's English class? Okay. So if you have attended it carefully, you can relate it with this, because by if you have not attended Saturday class, then this lecture is a little bit difficult for you to understand, because on Saturday I have told you simple questions formation, that how to change direct into indirect when WH kind of questions are given. But here, if your question starts with helping verb, now method is quite different. No doubt said to is changed into asked in that case also, in this case also. And this question form will change into assertive, but it will be started with if or whether, and in place of comma, inverted comma, nothing will be asked. So if he had invited you to lunch. Am I clear with this? Okay. So now, beta, I am going to give you some of the sentences. You apply this rule and start doing these sentences. Write down. And you are supposed to do these same sentences in your fair notebooks also. We'll be doing these questions in your fair notebook also. After asking your query, you keep yourself mute, beta. Now write down first one, He said to her, he said to her, shall I accompany you to Delhi? He said to her, shall I accompany you to Delhi? Okay. After writing this, write down. He said to me, is your father at home? He said to me, is your father at home? He said to me, is your father at home? Next is, I said to him, have you a spare pen? Have you a spare pen? Okay. I said to her, do you know how to play cricket? I said to her, do you know how to play cricket? Okay. So, bachche, do these sentences and type your answers in chat box. Only one student has raised his hand, that is Pranay. But it's better that you type your answers in chat box. Start typing first answer. I would be appreciating those children whose answer would come first. Those who would be writing first. Very good, Pranay. Very good, Simran, Dhiren. They all have written very correct answer. Very good, Divya. Very nice. You all are writing correct answer. It means this concept is clear to you. And if such kind of question forms are asked in the form of an integrated in your exam, you will be able to do. Very good, Nitya. Very good, Jasleen. Very nice. You all are sending me correct answer. So let's, Sudiksha, very good. Very nice. Now he said to her, shall I accompany you to Delhi? So this said to will change into he asked her. He asked her if he, first person will change according to subject. So this first person I will change according to subject. So that's why this I will change into he. So he asked her if he shall will change into should. If he should accompany. Now you is a second person. Second person will change according to object. So what will be there? He asked her if she should accompany her to Delhi. So bachche, whenever you do change in pronoun concept, So keep this point in your mind, this one, S-O-N. If you follow this thing, you will never commit any mistake. Otherwise, your narration will be considered wrong. If you are not able to do this, change in pronoun concept carefully. So he asked her if she should accompany. Her to Delhi. So many students are writing accompany him Delhi. It is wrong. I have told you, you is a second person. So second person will change according to object. So you will change according to her. So this is the reason that you will change into she. So the students who have written he, just follow this rule. Then your answer will not be wrong. Clear? Next we have, he said to me, is your father at home? He said to me. So this said to will change into, yes, let me see how many students have sent me correct answer. I want to appreciate all one. So many are there. So Diksha, Jasleen, Arzu, Divya, Aparan, Dhiren, Nitya, Pranay, Simran, all are writing correct answer. I'm really happy to see your performance, but I will be very much happy when my all students will be participating. Not even a single student will be sitting passive in my class, whether right, whether wrong, you type your answer, try to do. If your answer will be wrong, don't be afraid. You can learn from your mistakes. Okay. So he said to me, is your father at home? So he said to will change into ask. He asked me, tell me afterwards. He asked me, yes, if my father is will change into was. If my father was at home. If my father was at home. Clear? So he said to me, is your father at home? He asked me if my father was at home. Clear? I said to him, have you a spare pen? Very simple, very nice. So many students are typing in chat box and their all answers are correct. This said to will change into ask. Yes. So I asked him if, because this is starting with the auxiliary verb. So if it is starting with the auxiliary verb, I asked him if he, yes, have will change into have. If he had a spare pen. If he had a spare pen. Clear, beta? Next we have, I said to her, do you know how to play cricket? I said to her. So this said to will change into? Yes. I said to her, do you know how to play cricket? I said to will change into ask. I asked her, yes, I asked her if she knew. If she knew how to play. Okay, I asked her if she knew how to play. So said to will change into asked. Do you know how to play? So do you know, it will change into if she knew. If she knew how to play. Clear, beta? Now write down sentence number 5. You'll be doing this in your peer notebook and keep these notes very, very carefully with you. It will be very much beneficial, helpful for you to in your next class also, because such kind of narrations are asked. And these kind of narrations will be asked in integrated form, like paragraph will be given, dialogues will be given, and half of the narration will be solved. Like it is solved up to asked. But after that, students, what do they in a hurry? They write down that. And then they solve rest of the sentence. In this way, teacher will not read further sentence, will put cross. Because if asked is written, you cannot use conjunction that. If you are using conjunction that, sentence will be key. Yes, how to play cricket? Okay, and in place of question mark, also write down full stop in asserting. Don't commit that error. If you put a question mark, then also marks will be deducted. Yes, question mark is given, but you have to put full stop. For example, I said to you, what is your name? I asked you what your name was. Then full stop. Okay. So today in offline class, only cover note has come. When you people are coming, I'm waiting for all of you to eagerly to come. Because when I will be teaching offline, I think I will be enjoying more and you will be also enjoying more. Rather as compared to online. So your schools are open now from 6 to 12th. So you can come, right? But in proper school uniform. Okay. Next, you write down I said, shall I ever forget her? I said, shall I ever forget her? Now type. क्या लिख रहे हो चैट बॉक्स में? You type your answer. I said, shall I ever forget her? There is mistake in your answer. Whatever you are typing, you all are committing same mistake. Try to focus it very, very carefully. No doubt shall will change into should, but still all are committing same error. Nobody has sent me correct answer. Okay, I just help you how to do. I asked, okay, if I dash forget her, in place of question mark full stop. So in place of that dash, all are sending should, but it is I said, shall I ever forget her? I asked if okay, no problem. Suppose it he is given. Shall he? Suppose he is given, then should will come. I just want to ask you, if he is given, then should will come. He said, sorry, by mistake, I have written wrong. It is, shall I ever forget her? He said. Now do this answer. He said, shall I ever forget her? He said, if. Now tell me, what should be the correct answer? Yes. Still, so many students are sending me wrong answer. Question is, he asked, he said, shall I ever forget her? No, bachche, no. Not even a single student has sent this correct answer. You all are committing same mistake. No doubt you are applying correct rule, but you should use your common sense also. He said, shall I ever forget her? He asked if he. So you are changing shall into should. If he is given, why to should? Yes, Dhiren is the only one who has sent me correct answer. Yes, Simran is also writing correct. With he, in place of shall, will change into should, will be considering it is he, it is subject he. So with that, you consider will. So it will change into would. Because with I and we use shall, should, shall. And with others, we use will. So if we are writing he, why to write down should? We will be writing would. So he asked if he would forget her. So this is the correct answer, and you all have committed that error except one or two students. Jashan is raising her hand. Yes, Jashan, what do you want to ask?
Ma'am, ever kahan jayega?
Huh?
Ma'am, sir, question mein, shall I ever forget her? Usme ever kahan jayega?
Of ever will be written. He asked if he would ever forget her. By mistake, I haven't written, but you have to write down. He asked he would ever forget her. But my focus was only up to this, that shall should not be changed into should here because he is given. So this should be written would. Okay. He would, shall, he would ever forget her. Okay. So only up to this. Narrations are done. You jot down all these rules in your fear notebook, and all offline students who are coming tomorrow, bring your English notebooks with you. It will be easy for me to check offline. Okay? So those who are coming tomorrow, bring your English notebooks with you for getting it checked. Yes. Okay, now I'm going to over your lecture, over this class, you revise whatever is done in class.